In the fall of 2018, the Metropolitan Museum of Art will present an exhibition called Armenia, which is a look at Armenian art and culture from the 4th century AD, which is when Christianity arrives in Armenia, all the way up through the 18th century, which is the first moment that the printing press is being actively used in Echmiadzin, which is the mother see of the Church of Armenia. So this exhibition is one of a series of exhibitions that the Met has undertaken to look at the East Christian world, actually going all the way back to the 1970s. The Met did an exhibition called The Age of Spirituality, and that was followed by a succession of large exhibitions that looked at the Byzantine Empire, broadly speaking. And although Armenia has featured in some of the exhibitions that the Met has done in the past, and in fact there is Armenian art in the Met's permanent collection, this is an opportunity to really bring together a group of experts who can shine a spotlight on Armenia and put a real focus on the contributions that Armenian artists and patrons and thinkers and writers have made to broader world culture. Although the Byzantine Empire tends to dominate the story of civilization of the East Christian world, Armenians were actually very important players. One of the things that's interesting about that particular part of the world is that because it's at the western end of the eastern trade route that we know as the Silk Roads, there's a tremendous amount of movement of peoples and goods that had an impact on Armenian art and culture. So over time, they lived in a context where the Sasanian Persian Empire was the dominant force, then you have the rise of Byzantium, you have the arrival of the Seljuk Turks, and eventually of the Mongols. But throughout all of that, Armenians have also maintained a unique identity that really has its roots in their early conversion to Christianity and the creation of a special alphabet and an art form especially organized around the decorated word, the word of God. One of the things that's particularly exciting about the exhibition is about 70% of what people will see in this show is actually coming from the Republic of Armenia. There are about 150 objects overall in the exhibition, and major repositories of Armenian cultural holdings, such as the History Museum in Yerevan, the Matanadron, as well as Echmiadzin, will be coming here, many of these objects for the first time in the U.S., and some of them even traveling for the first time outside of Armenia. So in addition to major repositories of Armenian arts in the Republic of Armenia, we have loans coming from the Brotherhood of St. James in Jerusalem. We have things coming from Venice, San Lazzaro, which is where an Armenian community has been active since the Renaissance. And then a number of other lenders in Lisbon, the Gulbenkian, the British Library, the Getty Museum. And then there are a few objects from the Met's own collection that will be featured. So what makes this exhibition so special is that we have a large number of lenders who are gathering together a range of objects that feature some of the great achievements of Armenian art and culture: illuminated manuscripts, metalwork, ceramics, carved wood, carved stone objects, all the way from the early 4th century up until the 17th century. I hope people will come away understanding some of the things that are uniquely Armenian in thinking about the history of art. So, for instance, one of the art forms that I think people will find both very interesting and in some ways iconic, if they are familiar at all with Armenia, is the great tradition of hachkars, these tomb monuments and markers for specific events. The other would be the way in which the letter, the sacred letter, the word of God, was venerated and treated with in a way that is really quite distinctive when you think about other Christian cultures, where the word becomes a kind of living presence on the page of these illuminated manuscripts. Some of the painters, for instance, who really developed a kind of new visual vocabulary that both was open to new influences but also celebrated the Armenian-ness of this form of Eastern Christian approach to decoration was Taurus Rosslyn. And so some of the manuscripts featured in the show will actually be a look at specific artists whose identities we know because they left their names in colophons, and they also in some cases had followers or schools of paintings that developed around them. I think for me, a takeaway would be that people are introduced to Armenia. Many might not be familiar with Armenia as a place and might think about Armenians as a people, but this is an exhibition which really celebrates some of the great achievements of Armenian visual arts.